I have a quick question for you. Have you taken the opportunity to really look through the TechSmith Camtasia Library Media Assets and see what they offer? And did you receive recently the most recent bonus updates from TechSmith for their Camtasia Library Media Assets? That bonus package is filled with hundreds of assets that are terrific. I only have one teeny tiny little issue with them. I'm Naomi with the Top Shelf VA channel, your place for creativity and inspiration for business and life. And what is that teeny tiny little issue I have? Well, there are a ton of really great hand-drawn bonus assets, just like this down arrow. The problem is, it's black, and there's no way to change the black to another color. And I don't know about you, but black is fine if you live in a black and white world, and even if you live in a grayscale world, it's fine. But I like color, and I think probably you like color too. Or at least you want to have the opportunity to be able to change that black to a color that you would like. Well, today I'm going to show you a one-time effort on how to change that black image or icon to something different. And then from that point forward, you are going to be able to put it into your Camtasia library and use it at your heart's content. You can keep it black. You can make any colors you want. You can have it gray. You can have it blue. You can have it pink. You can have it yellow, whatever you want. So let's go ahead and see how to do this. Oh, and remember, before we get into that. Okay, a quick reminder to subscribe to the channel by clicking on that subscribe button and to click on that notification bell so you'll be notified every time I load a video. Okay, in order to do this, you will need any type of graphics program such as Photoshop or PowerPoint or anything similar to that. It really doesn't matter which graphics program you use. The theory will be the same no matter which program you use. I'll be demonstrating with both Photoshop and PowerPoint. For this demonstration, I'm going to change my Camtasia canvas color to white, which will make it easier for you to see what we are doing with the colors. To do this, click on the Canvas Options drop-down and select Project Settings. Then click on the Color drop-down and select White. Then Apply. Make sure you're on the Media section and click on the Library icon and click on the Bonus icons to open it. You'll have the bonus icons from the bonus pack that Camtasia just sent out. If you don't have that, the link is in the description below where you can get them. Let's go ahead and scroll to the icon image called Down Arrow 01 and drag it onto the canvas. It will also put it on track 1, a beautiful black arrow, but look at the properties panel. There is no way to change the color. Well, we're going to fix that by creating a new Camtasia library asset. As I said during my intro, you only have to do this once, and you can then use it over and over and over, changing the color at will. Put your cursor over the image file on the track 1 and right-click. Click on Update Media. Now what this does is open the location where this image is located in the Camtasia Library folder. Now I never, ever, I mean never, ever mess with the original of a file, no matter what I'm doing. So I'm going to put a copy of this into another folder on my hard drive. Let's go ahead and start with Photoshop. But if you only have PowerPoint, then you can skip to this time frame in the video for those instructions. From Photoshop, once it opens in the Layers panel, I'll double click to the far right of the image thumbnail to open the Layer Style window. Double click on the Color Overlay to open that window. And then double click on the color box to open it. Then right here in the hex code area, type in 7F, 7F, 7F. If it's easier for you to remember the RGB color, type in 127, 127, and 127. Click OK and OK again. Go back to the layer and right click, then choose Quick Export as PNG. It should open to the folder where you had saved your original black copy. Let's call this one Down Arrow Gray PNS for Photoshop. Click on Save. Okay, you're done. Now to skip to the Camtasia instructions, go to this time frame in the video to see how we're now going to use this new image. For the PowerPoint instructions, open PowerPoint and with a new presentation open with a blank layout,
click on Insert and Pictures. Go to where you copied the image and double-click it to insert it into PowerPoint. Now, if your design panel opens up, just go ahead and close it out. Holding your Shift key down, expand the image to the full height of the canvas. You need to make sure you hold the Shift key down to keep the ratio of the image intact. Now click on Picture Tools Format in the drop-down for color. Now select the image that says it's gray, accent color, 3, light. Click on Color and select Picture Color Options. Over here on the right, go ahead and set the saturation to 400% and the temperature to 11,500. Now right-click on the image and select Save Picture As. Save the picture in the same location as the original image. Let's go ahead and call this down arrow P and P for PowerPoint and click on Save. Now let's go back to Camtasia. In your Camtasia media bin, either click on the plus sign and select Import Media, or right-click with your mouse in an empty area and select Import Media. Go to the location you saved your customized image and double-click on it to open it into the media bin. I'm going to open both here so you can see both the Photoshop and PowerPoint versions side by side, along with the original black image. Now drag the gray image you created onto the canvas. Click on Visual Effects and drag and drop the Colorize onto your image. Voila! You can now use the Colorize section in the Properties panel to change the image to whatever color you want. If you have sharp eyes, you may see slight differences between Photoshop and PowerPoint, but really not that big a difference. Look at how bad or untrue the color is if you were to try and colorize on the original black image. It doesn't work at all. Now you can play as much as you want with color. Of course, you will want to put this into your library because you don't want to go through these steps all over again. Simply right-click on the image and select Add to Library, then rename the file to something identifiable. I've created my own folder for callouts that I use often, so I'll click and hold on the new Camtasia Library asset that I've renamed and move it to the callouts folder that I created. We now have a Camtasia asset we created only once, but can use and change the color simply by colorizing it, then changing the color from the Camtasia Properties panel. I hope you found this useful, and definitely click on that subscribe button and the bell icon so you will be notified anytime I load one of my varied and eclectic training videos. I've actually got a video coming up where I will be giving away one of my own free Camtasia library assets that I have created just for you. It's coming up next, so stay tuned. Until we meet again, have a wonderful day.